On March 30th, 2017, SpaceX achieved the world's first reflight of an orbital-class rocket. Following delivery of the payload, the Falcon 9 first stage returned to Earth for the second time. Curious to learn more about the first ever recycled rocket? Keep watching. In a milestone for the private spaceflight company, SpaceX successfully launched a reused Falcon 9 rocket booster into space, the same first stage that carried a bouncy house into space in 2016. The rocket booster had previously stuck a spectacular landing on a drone ship floating off the Florida coast, playfully named Of Course I Still Love You. That reused booster stuck its landing again on Thursday, March 30th, 2017. And on the same drone ship, no less, after blasting off from Cape Canaveral, Florida. This time, the rocket wasn't carrying an inflatable space pod, but was instead delivering a communication satellite to orbit for a company called SES. The rocket's vertical touchdown marks the 9th successful SpaceX landing in 14 tries, 6 of which have been on ships floating offshore. In April of 2016, SpaceX launched an inflatable habitat to the International Space Station, and then successfully turned the first stage of its Falcon 9 rocket around and flew it back to Earth, and parked it on a drone ship floating 185 miles off the US East Coast. The rocket landed instead of putting a hole in the ship or tipping over, so we're really excited about that, said SpaceX founder Elon Musk at a press conference after the landing. After launching from Cape Canaveral, the SpaceX rocket boosted its payload carrying Dragon capsule toward low Earth orbit, then turned around and headed for home about 4.5 minutes after the launch. As it approached the drone ship, the Falcon 9 righted itself, slowed down, and landed perfectly. The first stage of the Falcon 9 just landed on our Of Course I Still Love You drone ship, Dragon in good orbit, SpaceX tweeted in what must be the most understated announcement of the successful landing to cross our feed. To space and back in less than 9 minutes? Hello, future! In 2015, the company successfully sent a rocket back down on the ground, but landing at sea is much trickier than landing on land, because the ocean is a moving beast. Previous attempts failed when earlier rockets toppled over and experienced a rapid, unscheduled disassembly, i.e. they exploded. Musk said that before that April launch, company members were placing the odds of success at 2-to-1. We thought it was more likely than not that this mission would work, but still probably have a 1-in-3 chance of failure, Musk said. It's still quite tricky to land on a ship. It's quite a tiny target. The name of the game here is making spaceflight cheaper by developing reusable rockets that can ferry people and cargo into orbit, instead of spending millions of dollars building new launch rockets. Blue Origin, a company owned by Jeff Bezos, is also working on reusable rocket systems, and has successfully landed its new Shepard rocket on the ground multiple times. Musk and his team hope that once reusable rockets become more than a mere curiosity, they'll help reduce the often prohibitive costs of space travel, which is crucial for Musk's ambition plan to populate Mars within a few decades. His next goals include 2 successful launches of the same booster within 24 hours. The reflight mission made Falcon 9 the second orbit-capable rocket after the Space Shuttle to achieve partial reusability. The Falcon 9 flew from Launch Complex 39A at the Kennedy Space Center, the same space pad from which the shuttle began 82 of its missions, including its first and final flights. Reusability has long been a key objective for SpaceX, making the company's first launch in March of 2006. The small Falcon 1 vehicle carried a parachute system intended to bring its spent first stage back to Earth. SpaceX attempted to recover the first stages of 4 Falcon 1 vehicles. However, the rocket's first launch failed early in the mission and its third launch failed at stage separation, leaving the first stage unrecoverable. During the second and fourth launches, recovery attempts were unsuccessful. Following 3 failures, SpaceX achieved its first successful launch in September of 2008, with the fourth Falcon 1 successfully placing the demonstration payload RATSAT into low Earth orbit. The rocket made its fifth and final flight in July of 2009, successfully placing Malaysia's RazakSat satellite into orbit. For the RazikSat launch, the Falcon flew without a recovery system. SpaceX originally planned a family of Falcon rockets with the smaller single Falcon 1, a 5-engine Falcon 5, and a 9-engine Falcon 9. Two heavier vehicles, the Falcon 9S5 and 9S9, would have used two additional cores strapped to the first stage, with the 9S5 using Falcon 5 cores and the 9S9 Falcon 9 cores. The first five Falcon 9 launches used a version of the rocket which has retrospectively become known as the Falcon 9 version 1.0. Following the rocket's original design, the first stage was powered by 9 Merlin 1C engines arranged in a square 3x3 grid. The second stage uses single Merlin vacuum engine derived from the Merlin 1C. Both stages of the two-stage vehicle are fueled by RP-1 kerosene propellant, oxidized by liquid oxygen. Following its maiden flight, the Falcon 9 version 1.0 made four more launches, all carrying Dragon spacecraft. The first of these launches in December 2010 carried Dragon C-1. Dragon's maiden flight, C-1, completed two revolutions around the Earth before the capsule re-entered the atmosphere and splashed down in the Pacific Ocean. The final three launches of the original Falcon 9 carried Dragon missions to the International Space Station. The first, the Dragon C-2 plus COTS demonstration mission, followed by the first two operational flights under the Commercial Resupply Services Program. The earliest Falcon 9 launches carried parachutes, which were to have been used to recover the first stage. However, this was abandoned due to the stage disintegrating during re-entry, before the parachutes could be deployed. Instead, SpaceX began to investigate using the stage's engines to make a powered descent and landing. Alongside this, an approved Falcon 9 vehicle, the Falcon 9 version 1.1, was developed. In order to help with the reusability development program, SpaceX constructed a test vehicle named Grasshopper, which is a single-engine Falcon version 1.0 first stage with fixed landing gear. In 2012 and 2013, Grasshopper made a series of test flights from SpaceX's facility at McGregor, Texas. After 8 successful low-altitude flights, Grasshopper was replaced with a new 3-engine development vehicle using the stretched first stage of the Falcon 9 version 1.1. This new test vehicle introduced the retractable landing legs and later grid fins that would fly with operational Falcon 9 rockets, making for successful flights in 2014 before a sensor issue led to its failure during the fifth mission. Before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can continue to improve our content and make these videos better for you. Plus, be sure to subscribe to the channel and don't forget to hit the bell button so that you don't miss any of our weekly videos. The Falcon 9 version 1.1 stretched both the first and second stages of the rocket and upgraded from Merlin 1C to Merlin 1D engines. The first stage engines were rearranged into the octagonal or octaweb configuration that is now familiar. The upgrades increased the rocket's payload capacity, giving it sufficient margin on some missions for powered recovery tests following first stage separation. The first few Falcon 9 version 1.1 launches tested restarting the first stage engines after separation, attempting to achieve a controlled descent into the ocean. The rocket first flew with legs in April 2014, and grid fins to provide additional control were added ahead of January 2015's launch of the CRS-5 Dragon mission. During the CRS-5 launch, SpaceX deployed its first ASDS, just read the instructions, into the Atlantic Ocean to provide the returning stage with a landing platform. A converted barge, the ASDS, was positioned downrange and left unmanned for the landing attempt. Although the first stage reached the drone ship, it depleted its hydraulic fluid during descent, resulting in a hard and uncontrolled landing and explosion. The next Dragon launch, CRS-6, made another landing attempt using just read the instructions 3 months later. The stage toppled over on touchdown before again exploding. The final mission for which Just Read the Instructions was deployed was the CRS-7 launch in June of 2015. Towards the end of the first stage flight, a composite overwrapped pressure vessel, COPV, broke loose inside the second stage oxidizer tank. The tank overpressurized, resulting in structural failure and the disintegration of the Falcon. Just read the instructions was subsequently converted back into a regular barge. However, her name was reused for a new drone ship commissioned for launches out of Vandenberg Air Force Base. A replacement East Coast ASDS was also introduced, named, Of Course, I Still Love You. The two vessels are named after ships in the works of science fiction author Ian M. Banks. When Falcon returned to flight after the CRS-7 failure, it was in a new configuration which has become known informally as the Falcon 9 version 1.2 or Falcon 9 Full Thrust. This version of the Falcon 9 has upgraded engines and uses super cold liquid oxygen to increase oxidizer density, allowing a greater mass to be carried relative to the volume of its tanks. The second stage was further stretched compared to the Falcon 9 version 1.1. The full thrust configuration's improved performance allows for recovery attempts on a greater range of missions, including geosynchronous launches such as the reflight launch. On missions that do not require the rocket's full performance, the first stage can now return to the launch site for a touchdown on dry land. In December of 2015, the first flight of the Falcon 9 version 1.2 carried 11 Orbcomm communication satellites into low Earth orbit, with the first stage making its first attempt to fly back to Cape Canaveral. A landing pad, Landing Zone 1, was constructed on the site of Launch Complex 13, a former Atlas launch pad which was used between 1958 and 1978. While the second stage continued to orbit, successfully deploying its payload, the first stage achieved a flawless landing at Landing Zone 1, marking the first time SpaceX had successfully brought the stage back to Earth. The Falcon 9 version 1.1 made its final flight in January of 2016 with an unsuccessful attempt to land on the new Just Read the Instructions after lifting off from Vandenberg Air Force Base with the Jason 3 satellite. One of the first stage's legs failed to lock into position and the stage toppled over on landing. In March 2016, SpaceX made its first recovery attempt with Of Course I Still Love You during the launch of the SES-9 satellite. The first attempt to recover the first stage from a geosynchronous mission, the first stage returned to the drone ship, but did not have sufficient fuel remaining to achieve a survivable landing. The next launch, the CRS-8 Dragon mission, achieved the first successful landing at sea. Launched on April 8, 2016, the 23rd flight of the Falcon 9 and the third of the version 1.2 configuration lifted off from Space Launch Complex 40 at the Cape Canaveral Air Force Station to send Dragon on its way to the International Space Station. After propelling the Falcon 9 for the first 2.5 minutes of her mission, the first stage, Core 1021, separated. 6 minutes later, following boost back, re-entry and landing burns, the stage touched down atop the drone ship. A year later, following refurbishment and testing, the same first stage was ready to fly again. Thanks for watching, everyone. Do you think it's possible to reuse the second stage of the Falcon 9 rockets? Did you learn anything new in this video? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe and I'll see you next time on the channel.